Dakota First. KX News at 10 starts now.
Good evening, I'm Lauren Culver.
And I'm Nicholas Pollock. Thank you for watching KX News.
And tonight's top story is the nationwide conversation continues over how to end police brutality against minorities. What? One major focus has been on increasing behavioral and mental health services.
That's right. And Renee Cooper joins us to talk about an effort that's been in the works for years now, right here in the Peace Garden State. Renee?
Hi, Lauren and Nicholas. It's true. We first reported about the North Dakota Department of Human Services' plan to create a social detox facility in the Bismarck-Mandan area. That was about 2 years ago. The plan has always been to have staff like counselors and clinical specialists available for 911 calls that may not be best suited for police.
When a community has limited resources, everything falls on us.
In fact, in 2019, Bismarck police responded to 428 detox calls. That's over 10% more calls than the year before.
If you're drunk in public and you basically can't care for yourself, it's not a criminal act. There's nothing illegal about it, but there's limited resources in the area to take care of them.
This spurred a conversation between Bismarck police and these guys with the West Central Human Service Center about keeping those that aren't necessarily doing something illegal out of jail. The problem is, when officers respond to public intoxication calls, there wasn't another place to take people to sober up for the night.
Some of those discussions have been ongoing the last couple of years.
Now, as of May 1st, there is a crisis center in the capital city. We can't show you the exact location, but people are taken there to detox.
It includes a 24-hour statewide crisis call center. So we've contracted with First Link to where they'll have trained call center specialists that will conduct an assessment over the phone. But if a referral process is then needed, we then have a 24-hour regional mobile crisis response team
made up of nurses, clinical specialists, addiction counselors, and more to respond alongside police in behavioral health crises.
During the day, after hours, weekends, and holidays.
We've had law enforcement bring persons over during the day shift that they encounter in the street, whether they're homeless or just having issues. Just last week, there was an incident of that where the law enforcement stayed long enough to get the person connected with us.
That's the same thing with mental illness. And in the history of law enforcement, in general, law enforcement has, while trying to help somebody, had to hurt them because they are resistant to law enforcement. We don't want to do that. We'd rather have a professional with us.
Well, West Central is able to provide all of this through a contract with the nonprofit Dakota Foundation and with money set aside by state lawmakers in 2019. And Lauren and Nicholas, the goal is to have the services available in all 8 human service regions in the state by later this fall.
Renee Cooper, thank you very much.
First responders never know the extent of any call they respond to, and that's the reason